We are going to get started, first grade. Hello, hello. Welcome to music class. I am so excited to see everybody today. All right, and the first thing I want to do, as we do every single time, is say hello. So I'm going to go first, and then I want you guys to echo me and use your hands. All right, me first. Hello, boys and girls. Ooh, looking good, everybody. Great job. Great job. All right, next thing I want to do, we're going to go right into our tas and TTs. Today, I am going to be using my rhythm sticks, but you can use your rhythm sticks, you can use your scarf, you can use your shaker, you can use your scraper. Your choice, okay? Your choice. When you're ready, go ahead and show me. Sit in that ready position so that I know, and we are going to get going here in just 1 second. Remember, if you don't have your music kit, you can always use your hands to clap, your hands to scrape, or you could put something inside of your hands and maybe even shake it a little bit. All right, lots and lots of choices, lots and lots of options. Excuse me. All right, guys, repeat after me. Ta, ta, ti, ti, ta. Ti, ti, ta, ta, ta. Ti, 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 ti. Oh, you know what? I'm having a few people ask me, how would I use a scarf? So you know what? I'm going to use my scarf to show you. Got to get into my music kit. All right. Here is Mrs. Porter's scarf. Okay. And I'm going to go like this. Ti, ti, ta, ta, ta. There we go. Ti, 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 ta. Ta, ta. Ooh, good resting, guys. Rest, rest. Ti, ti, ta. Ta, rest. Ta, rest. Yes, 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 yes. Ti, ti, ta, ta, ti, ti. Last one. Ta, ta, rest, ta. Great job, guys. Go ahead and put those away. Today, boys and girls, we are going to continue our Nutcracker adventure. We're going to finish watching the story of the Nutcracker, and then we are going into our amazing Nutcracker adventure. Now, remember, the Nutcracker is a ballet, which is a story that is told only through music and dance. There's no singing, there's no talking. It's just listening to the music and dancing to it. And it was based off of a book. So back in the olden days, there were no movies. So going to the theater and watching things like a ballet was kind of like their form of movie. So the Nutcracker was based off of a book called The Nutcracker and the Mouse King. And they turned it into this performance called a ballet for people to come and watch. So kind of cool. It's kind of like, I don't know, how the Grinch That Stole Christmas used to be a Dr. Seuss book, and then they turned it into a movie. Same thing with the Nutcracker. The Nutcracker was a book that they turned into a dancing story. So I'm going to now share my screen with you guys. And we are going to look at the Nutcracker. All right, here we go. Do, do, do. And open it up. And now we're going to go ahead and listen to the Nutcracker. I believe we stopped right around the part where they were talking about the different kinds of dances. Oh, not progressive. All right, Rooney, here we go.
Clara and the prince were seated on a huge plush rug on the floor, and then the dancing began. dancers from Spain spun into the room. Leaping and twirling as they brought the guests mugs filled with hot cocoa made from rich Spanish chocolate.
Can you guys hear this okay?
Arabian women in veils danced like rising steam as they offered Clara and the prince hot Arabian coffee. Chinese dancers delivered Mandarin tea. Then, Russian men in fur hats and loud boots sprang into the room to deliver candy canes. Sweet shepherdesses with blonde braids and rosy cheeks brought their gift of the almond sugar known as marzipan. And then a ruckus. A giant gingerbread woman called Mother Ginger danced in. Eight little ginger children came tumbling out from under the frosting ruffles of her gingerbread skirt and danced the silliest, sweetest dance. Then, the dreamy sound of a harp announced the entrance of an entire garland of flowers. Who danced in beautiful, mesmerizing patterns as a single dewdrop floated above them. Clara thought it was the most wonderful waltz she'd ever heard. Then the harp continued and an achingly beautiful, wordless song began to play. The Sugar Plum Fairy came back with her own prince to dance them farewell. At first, it was just the two of them. Then an entire court came together to bid Clara and the Nutcracker Prince farewell. They helped their guests back into the sleigh and tucked warm blankets around them. Clara looked at the prince, sad that this marvelous adventure was over too soon. "I wish it would never end," she said to him. "All of this. I wish it could go on forever." Clara's Nutcracker Prince looked at her fondly and touched her cheek softly. "It will go on forever," he said, "for those who have an eye to see it." Clara wanted to stay awake for the journey back through the snow forest, but she just couldn't keep her eyes open. She drifted into a warm, sweet dream. The next morning, Clara awoke. It was daylight, meaning it was now Christmas morning. She found herself still under the Christmas tree, where she had fallen asleep the night before. She was surprised to find that her toy Nutcracker was still in her arms. Had the whole thing been just a dream? Or had the magic of Christmas come to life? And had she seen it with her own eyes? The end. Thanks for listening to Classical Kids Storytime from American Public Media.
All right, everybody. How'd you guys like the story of the Nutcracker? Was it pretty good? Yeah? Oh my gosh, I love that you guys were loving it. All right. So here's what we're going to do now. Actually, I'm going to share my screen one more time. And we are going to go back and watch, or we're going to go ahead and look at our Nutcracker stuff. All right. So here's the thing. I made myself into a Bitmoji and I look a little bit cold. Oh, I'm talking about Russia. Russia is where the Nutcracker was first performed and where Peter Tchaikovsky, the person that wrote the music for the Nutcracker, that's where he lived. Russia would be so cold to visit in the winter. Brr! I'm so glad that we learned some background about the Nutcracker. But boys and girls, who's in the bottom corner of my screen? Uh-oh. You know, thinking about that Mouse King, he doesn't seem so tough. Uh-oh. I'm seeing somebody getting a little closer. In fact, I bet that he couldn't hurt a fly! Uh-oh. Oh, no! It's the Mouse King! Did I ever mention how much I love your moustache? No? Well, would you like some cheese? Mice like cheese, right? Oh, Schnikes, this isn't good. Help! Uh-oh. I think the Mouse King just took Bitmoji Mrs. Porter. Oh, no! Help! The Mouse King has imprisoned me in this jiggly jello! Hurry and go listen to the march and then from the Nutcracker so I can escape! Will you guys help Mrs. Porter, the Bitmoji, escape? Will you help her? Oh my gosh, I'm seeing so many yeses. All right, boys and girls, here is what I need you to do. We are going to be listening to the march from the Nutcracker, and I need you to help me by keeping a beat. So we are going to go like this. When you hear this part of the Nutcracker, can you guys go for me? Can you keep like that? Can you keep a beat like that? Bum, ba da da da. Then you're going to hear this part. Dun da dun da dun da da bum ba dum 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 ba da. Try that with me one more time. Bum ba dum ba dum ba dum bum ba dum 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 ba da. So that whole beginning is going to look like this. Bum ba da dum bum 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 ba bum ba da dum. Yeah. I think you guys can do it. We are going to be doing that 4 different times. But in the middle of those times, we're going to have to listen and I will show you some moves to do. Here we go. Here we go. ready? That was great. You guys rock. Let's see what happens next. Oh, I didn't mean to click on that. Just kidding. I meant to click on this. Thanks for your help. I'm off to the land of sweets to find the Nutcracker. But look who's on my tail. Uh-oh. Whew! I made it. Let's go watch of some of the famous dances. Maybe the Nutcracker is there. And you know what? We are going to learn a little bit more about that next time. I'm going to stop us right there for right now because I have something else I want to talk to us about. Okay? So, first thing, my lovelies, is how many people have heard of, how many people have heard that we are going to be doing a sing-along? Has anyone heard about that already? Yes, awesome. Some people have heard about it already. That is great. Well, here is what's gonna happen. I wanna explain it to you so that you know exactly what you need to do, okay? Every single boy and girl in Star School is going to help us by making a sign that's going to be part of our sing-along. You are going to take a piece of paper or poster board or anything you can write on, and you're going to write a phrase, a few different words that Mrs. Porter is going to tell you what it is, and you are going to make a sign, and you're going to hold it up and smile and have mom or dad or grandma or an adult take a picture of you, and you're going to send it to me either on Class Dojo, or you can email it to me. Class Dojo is probably pretty easy though. So you're gonna take a picture of you holding your sign and you're gonna send it to me, and I'm going to take all those pictures and I'm going to make a movie out of them so that we know the words to all of our songs. It is gonna be so cool. So I'm gonna show you right now how you can do that, okay? So I'm gonna share my screen one last time, all right? And you're gonna see that I have, do you guys see my first grade music Google Classroom? Can you guys see that right now? At the very, very top of my Google Classroom, the very first thing in the stream tells you how to create that sing-along, that sign, okay? And it says, open up the flyer for more information, all right? But what you're going to do is you're going to make a paper poster with your assigned phrase, so the words that I tell you to put on it, and you can decorate it afterwards however you want. Then you're going to take a picture of you holding it, and then you're going to send the picture back to me. Now you're thinking, Mrs. Porter, what words do I have to choose? Well, down here I have all of the first grade teachers, and you're going to click on the teacher that is yours. So if you have Mrs. Geisel, you're clicking here. Mrs. Oberdick is clicking here, and then we just kind of keep going. So Mr. Donegan's up here, and Mrs. Howard's here. And after you are done, okay, after you are done, you're going to click on it, figure out, find your name, and whatever your name is next to, those are going to be the words that you are going to put on your sign, okay? You have until Wednesday to turn your sign in, okay? You have until Wednesday to turn it in to me. So please, 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 please make sure that you get that in because it is going to look so cool. And I am so excited to get to make this sing-along video with all of you. All right, so all of the information is right here. I also have all the information under classwork. So if you can't find it on the stream, I have all the sing-along information here too. All right, and your teachers also have it. So if you have a question, you can always message me or you can message your teacher and they will also be able to help you. Give me a thumbs up if that sounds good. Give me a thumbs up if that sounds good. Oh man, you guys, okay. Awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. I'm seeing lots of thumbs up. That's great. Alrighty, my friends. Well, we have about 4 minutes left. I'm going to leave you guys just a little bit early today. All right. But if you want to get started, maybe you have a little bit of time right now that you could even get started on your sign. All right. So I'm going to say goodbye. I cannot wait for you guys to say goodbye back to me using your hands. And I will see you guys on Tuesday for another awesome music class. All right. So I will stay on for a few extra seconds after I say goodbye for people that do have questions for me. Okay. But if after I say goodbye, you don't have questions, you can leave. All right. Here we go. Goodbye, boys and girls. All right. Again, if you have questions, you can stay on. And if you don't have questions, you guys can go and start your sign or wherever else you might have to go next. All right. Have a great day, everybody. See you later.